Hello everyone. Today, in this module, you will be learning about one of the most important component of staffing, that is recruitment. Let's start with that. All of you know the meaning of recruitment. It is the process of stimulating people to apply for vacant job positions in the organization. So it can be defined as the process of searching for prospective candidates and stimulating them to apply for jobs in an organization. These are the four activities which are involved in recruitment. First, you need to identify different sources of manpower supply. Then you need to assess their validity, whether they are valid according to your requirements. Then choosing the most suitable source or the sources according to your requirement, whether you need skilled workers or unskilled workers. Inviting applications from the prospective candidates for the vacancies. Now, recruitment, this can be done in two ways. Either vacancies can be filled from within the organization, then it is called as the internal recruitment, or it can be done from outside the organization, then it is termed as the external recruitment. First, we will study about the internal sources. Under internal sources of recruitment, the vacant job positions are filled by inducing the existing employees of the organizations. It involves two methods, one transfer and second one is your promotion. Number one, transfers. It involves shifting of an employee from one job to another, one department to another, one branch to another, or from one shift to another, without a substantive change in the status of the employee. Like if you are shifting a clerk from accounts department to the purchase department on the same position, then it will be termed as the transfer. It may lead to changes in duties and responsibilities, working condition, etc., but not necessarily salary. It is a good source of filling the vacancies with the employees from overstaffed departments. Like we have more employees in one department and deficiency of employees is there in another department, then we can shift some of the employees from the overstaffed department to the understaffed department. As there is no change in the level of the employees, so it is practically a horizontal movement of the employees. It can also be used for training of employees for learning different jobs, which you better know as, yes, job rotation. And we all know why this method of training is used, so that employee can get knowledge about different jobs in the organization. So whenever there is an emergency, he can be asked to handle any of the job. Job transfers are also helpful in avoiding termination and in removing individual problems and grievances. At the time of transfer, you must make it sure that employee to be transferred to another job is capable of performing it. Like if you are transferring the clerk from accounts department to the purchase department, he must be able to know how to maintain records in the purchase department. Then example they have given, transfer of clerk from accounts department to the purchase department. Next one is your promotion. Business enterprises generally follow the practice of filling higher jobs by promoting employees from lower jobs within the same organization. It leads to shifting an employee to a higher position, which will be accompanied with higher responsibilities, facilities, status and pay. It is a vertical shifting of employees. It helps to improve the motivation, loyalty and satisfaction level of employees. And secondly, it has a great psychological impact over the employees. Because if we are promoting one employee, then it will lead to a chain of promotions at other levels also. Others will also expect that they may be promoted in future, so they will be motivated to perform better. Like if you are प्रमोटिंग अ क्लर्क टू द अकाउंटेंट पोस्ट, दैट इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ प्रमोशन. नाउ हाउ इज इट बेनिफिशियल फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन? फर्स्ट, एम्प्लॉइज आर मोटिवेटेड टू इम्प्रूव देयर परफॉर्मेंस. सेम एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू आर प्रमोटिंग एम्प्लॉय फ्रॉम मिडल लेवल टू द हायर लेवल, देन द सम एम्प्लॉयज एट लोअर लेवल, दे विल बी motivated to show better performance so that they can be considered to be promoted to the vacancy that has arisen due to promotion of the employee from middle to the upper level. It also simplifies the process of selection and placement. This is more reliable way of recruitment since the candidates are already known to the organization. They already know about the rules and regulations, so they are already comfortable with the rules and regulations, so there will be less chances of employees turnover. It is a tool of training the employees to prepare them for higher jobs. Also, people recruited from within the organization do not need induction training because already they are familiar with the organization structure. It has the benefit of shifting workforce from the surplus department to those where there is shortage of staff. Filling of jobs internally is cheaper because you need not advertise the vacancies. You need not follow that complicated procedure of selection. So it is quite economical for the organization. Now, it also suffers from some of the limitations, like when vacancies are filled through internal promotions, then the scope for induction of the fresh talent is reduced. The new people will come to the organization, they will bring new ideas. But if you are filling the vacancies from within the organization, you will be deprived of these new ideas. Secondly, the employees may become lethargic if they are sure of time-bound promotions, like in case of government organizations. A new enterprise cannot use internal sources of recruitment because a new enterprise will not have that much of the manpower that it can fill the vacancies from within the organization. The spirit of competition among the employees may be hampered because they don't have to compete with the outsiders for the same job. Frequent transfers of employees may reduce the productivity of the organization because by the time he gets settled on one job, then he is transferred to the another job. Then he may not show his best on a particular job. Always he will be suffering from that insecurity that he can be transferred to any job at any time. Next is external sources of recruitment. So when vacancies are filled from outside the organization, then it is termed as the external sources of recruitment. And it is used when the existing staff may be insufficient or they may not fulfill the eligibility criteria of the jobs to be filled. Now, under external sources, we will study in total 10 methods. First one is your direct recruitment. You must have seen at some industrial site, a notice is placed on the factory gate specifying the details of the vacancies. Or like vacancy for peons, sweepers, yes or no? Yes. So this is your direct recruitment or the recruitment at the factory gate. Under the direct recruitment, a notice is placed on the notice board of the enterprise specifying the details of the jobs available. Job seekers assemble outside the premises of the organization on the specified date and selection is done on the spot. But one thing that you have to keep in mind, it is used only for unskilled or semi-skilled jobs. You cannot appoint the managers this way. एंड द वर्कर्स हु आर रिक्रूटेड थ्रू डायरेक्ट रिक्रूटमेंट दे आर नोन एज द कैजुअल और द बदली वर्कर्स एंड दे आर पेड रेम्यूनरेशन ऑन डेली वेज बेसिस. दिस मैथड ऑफ रिक्रूटमेंट इज़ वेरी इनएक्सपेंसिव एज इट डजेंट इन्वॉल्व एनी कॉस्ट ऑफ एडवर्टाइजिंग द वैकेंसीज. इट इज़ सुटेबल फॉर फिलिंग कैजुअल वैकेंसीज स्पेशली वैन देयर इज अ रश ऑफ वर्क और वैन सम ऑफ द परमानेंट वर्कर्स आर एबसेंट. Second is your casual callers. You must have noticed that after completing education, many people keep on submitting their resume in reputed organizations so that whenever any vacancy is there, they may be considered for that vacancy. This is called as the casual callers. Many reputed business organizations keep a database of unsolicited applicants in their offices, and whenever there is any vacancy, you can prepare a list of such job seekers, and these can be screened to fill the vacancies as they arise. And the major merit, it is quite economical. Next one is your advertisement that you all are aware of. Advertisement in newspapers or trade and professional journals is generally used when a wider choice is required. And you can give advertisement in the local newspaper if you require employees for the lower levels. But in case you require employees for the middle or the higher levels, then you can go for trade or the professional journals. Most of the senior positions of the industry as well as commerce are filled by this method. The advantage, you will get a wider choice. Secondly, you can give information about the organization. You can give complete information about the job as well as the salary offered for that job. But the major disadvantage, because in our country there is a major problem of unemployment. So whenever any vacancy is published, it is advertised, it may bring in a flood of response and many times from quite unsuitable candidates. Next one is employment exchange. These are being run by government in almost every state. These are also a good source of recruitment for unskilled and skilled operative jobs. And in some cases, compulsory notification of the vacancies to employment exchange is required by law. So, employment exchanges help to match personnel demand and supply by serving as a link between the job seekers and employers. So, employers can refer to employment exchanges to fill the vacancies in their organizations. But the major disadvantage of this method is records of employment exchanges are often not up to date, and many of the candidates referred by them may not be found suitable. Like government is running government employment exchanges, same way in private sector there are placement agencies and management consultants. These are the employment exchanges run by private enterprises. They provide a nationwide service in matching personnel demand and supply. They keep a biodata of large number of candidates and recommend suitable names to their clients. And in lieu of this, their services, they charge some commission. Management consultancy firms, as the name itself suggests, it is used to recruit technical, professional and managerial personnel. They specialize in middle level and top level executive placements. Campus recruitment, like in case of IIMs, IITs, what the companies prefer to do, they prefer to interview the final year students or the pass outs from those colleges, and recruitment is done on the spot. That is termed as the campus recruitment. Colleges and institutes of management and technology have become a popular source of recruitment for technical, professional and managerial jobs. Many big companies maintain a close liaison with the universities, vocational schools and management institutes to recruit qualified personnel for their jobs. It is more commonly used to recruit engineers, computer programmers, and MBAs, etc. Next one is recommendations from present employees. Sometimes the employer may ask present employees whether some good candidates are known to them who can be considered for filling the vacancies. So many firms encourage their employees to recommend the names of their friends and relatives to fill the vacant job positions. And they are likely to be good employees because their background is sufficiently known to you. A type of preliminary screening takes place because the present employees know both the company and the candidates, and they would try to satisfy both. Labor contractors. These are used in case of when you need to fill the vacancies for lower levels, like for the construction. Workers are recruited through labor contractors who are themselves employees of the organization. They are the people who supply labor at a very short notice. So these are the people who keep in touch with the labor in villages and rural areas, and they can provide you the required number of the unskilled workers at a very short notice. Next one is advertising on television. You can also give advertisement of the vacancy on the television. The practice of telecasting of vacant posts over television channels is gaining importance these days. The detailed requirements of the job and the qualities required to do it are publicized along with the profile of the organization where the vacancy exists. Web publishing, like sites, there are sites, monster.com, naukri.com. You can give vacancies on these sites. So these are generally visited both by the employer as well as the employees. So these are the different sources of external recruitment. Now, what are the advantages of external sources? The first one, you will get qualified personnel. By using external sources, the management can attract qualified and trained people to apply for vacant jobs in the organization. Wider choice. In case of the internal sources, there is a limited choice. While in case of external sources, you will get more number of applicants. So you will have a wider choice. Fresh talent. You will get opportunity to get new ideas, fresh talent. So it will bring new blood in the organization with new ideas. Competitive spirit. If a company taps external sources, then obviously the existing staff will have to compete with the outsider. They will work harder to show better performance so that for the higher level jobs, instead of giving preference to the employees from outside, company gives preference to them. Demerits. Dissatisfaction among existing staff. So if the organization fills higher level jobs from the outside the organization, then some of the existing staff members, they may feel dissatisfied, and it may cause frustration among existing employees. Lengthy process, because first the vacancies are to be publicized, then you will have to wait for the applications, then the selection procedure will be followed. So it becomes a lengthy process. Costly process. It is very costly to recruit staff from external sources. A lot of money has to be spent on advertisement and processing of applications. So now we can sum up it like this. Sources of recruitment, two sources, internal and external. In internal, two sources are there, promotion and transfer. In external, there are total of 10 sources. Direct recruitment, casual callers, advertising, employment exchanges run by government, placement agencies run by private sector, then campus recruitment in case of MBAs, engineers, etc. Recommendations from present employees, labor contractors, especially in construction work, advertising on television, web publishing. So this is all about the sources of recruitment. In the next module, we will study about the next process, that is selection process. Till then, good day to all of you. Take very good care of yourself.